What's going on, guys? It is your motivation guy. That's right, your friend, the one and only Keith Allen. I just want to encourage you. I know every single day we like to focus, you know, about all of our issues, you know, on all of our problems, but what if we just take one day to encourage other people? It is life-changing, and I want you to try that this week. Go get it. So, as most of us already know, cash cups are a big thing in Fortnite, right? And hopefully we start to see more of them in the future because they're honestly pretty good practice and the money really helps as well. And you know, if you'd like to get your hands on some of that money, like I definitely would, definitely stick around because in this video, we're gonna be going over some crucial tips and tricks that you should always be using when you play in cash cups. Last thing, ladies and gentlemen, before we get started, let's do today's question of the day. I need my drum roll. All right, so today's question is, which weapon in Fortnite have you liked the least? You know, it could be a weapon from the current meta, you know, a long time ago, or any time in the game's history. Personally, I think the original infantry rifle was one that didn't even shoot that straight. It was pretty bad, okay? But the semi-auto sniper is pretty far down my list as well. But you know what? Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Definitely want to know. But before we start, we got to talk about one of the best websites around, guys, ProGuys.com. Okay, so have you ever watched a pro like Benji, Monger, or Lechi and just thought, man, I wish I was that good? If you have, like, you know, many of us have, you know, you're in luck because all three of these players have worked with us to create courses on ProGuys.com to help you guys all improve. And on top of all of this, we have a ton of other courses from some of the most knowledgeable players in the entire competitive scene. We also offer 24/7 on-demand coaching to help you guys become a Fortnite legend. If any of this awesome stuff interests you, head on over to ProGuys.com to get started today. All right, guys, it's about that time. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to sit back, relax, and grab some of my favorite candy. That's what I'm talking about. It's that Bunchy Crunch, and let's get this going. But without further ado, let's get into the first tip of this video, which relates to your early game. The first tip is to be consistent with your drop spot. All right, guys, so being consistent with your drop spot is the first tip on this list, and it's easily one of the most important. If you land at a bunch of different locations, you're gonna have an okayest knowledge of all of them, right? That's cool, I get it, but it's so much better if you have complete knowledge of just one spot. For example, you know, I know many people that land at, you know, the Northwest Castle. And, you know, if you practice it over and over, you can find the best loot route in case you're contested. And also, you can master exactly where to open your glider and, you know, get the first drop there. So wherever you're contested, it's just really hard to lose unless, like, the other player is just better than you. Also, when it comes to early game, guys, make sure you have a consistent loot route that you go through every single time. You can use the website lootlake.info to see all the loot spawns in your drop spot as well to find the most efficient path for looting. And once you've got the loot round down, practice landing there over and over again and just learn, you know, where to open your glider so you can land first every single time. Okay, so think about it like this. If you get the first drop and the most consistent loot every single time, you're not gonna be beaten unless you genuinely just get outplayed. One major mistake, guys, I see so many newer players making is, you know, taking the wrong fights. It's actually surprisingly simple to know when to take fights, so let's just discuss that real fast. You know, a few times that you should take a fight will be like if you're in the zone or the zone has just popped up. You have loot, health and materials you're comfortable with, and with the odds of a third party are low, like, you know, if you're in a quiet part of the zone or if you're fighting in the earlier parts in the game. And also, guys, you should usually fight if you get an advantage, all right? This doesn't mean to just W key a fight in storm because you hit the guy for 50 damage. But it does mean that, you know, you're in a decent position where the fight is realistic and you have something to gain from it, right? It's typically worth taking a fight if you have an immediate advantage. Most notably, if you hit the first shots and take a lot of their health off, if they have poor loot or materials, or if they're on white health when you shoot first at them. A few times you should not take fights include when you're not confident in your loot, materials, or even health, because, you know, you need all three of those to have a good fight. You know, another example is when the storm is far away and you need to rotate. You always want to rotate early and get in. So fighting mid-rotation is typically bad unless they're already low and it's a free kill. Finally, you shouldn't take fights against players who have much better position or have the ability to hold you in storm. So if you're in moving zones, don't shoot at the guy who's in height in front of the zone. Though, that'll get you killed. Trust me, I know. Okay, so if you've ever played a cash cup before, you're gonna probably know the importance of winning fights. Cash cups, guys, are typically, you know, full of relatively aggressive players, and you're gonna have to grab plenty of kills if you wanna end up placing in these cups. So practicing your mechanics and learning to win all types of scenarios is super important. So if you're bad at creative and you know you can't win box fights or build fights in there, then definitely practice that first. But once you're pretty good at creative, start bringing your W key skills into the real game, okay? So hop into Arena, you know, get in a scrim match or even a pub if you're into that, and practice W king and get a ton of kills. This is going to force you to practice doing the real thing in a real game environment, and you're going to find yourself improving much faster doing it this way. So creative can only bring you guys so far. So when you're insane mechanically already, it's more important to just practice in game and get better at more realistic fights instead of just those perfect fights when you both have the same loadout, you know, the same heals and even the same health and pretty much, you know, really the same everything. So one more amazing tip is to carry an RPG or sniper, or even both if you're about that in your Cash Cup games. You know, we watched a solo Cash Cup from Sin Aspect, and believe it or not, man, about 30 to 40% of his kills were directly from a sniper shot. And if you watch any major pros like, you know, Wavy Jacob, Booga, Unknown, among so many others, you're gonna see how they abuse RPGs super often and get a ton of kills. These weapons are pretty low skill for the most part, but super high reward. So they're definitely gonna be worth using it. All right, guys, so now that we've gone over a few all-around tips, we're gonna go over a few micro tricks you can use during your actual fight to give yourself an edge in those one-on-one engagements that you're gonna run into pretty much every single game. All right, guys, so let's get into it. All right, guys, so the first micro action we're gonna go over is a handy trick that you can use whenever you carry an RPG. And as we said in the last tip, it's pretty important to carry an RPG or a sniper in a Cash Cup game. So the first thing you want is a wall that's at or below 150 HP. So if your opponent has a fully built wood wall, this technique is amazing. If it's a brick or metal, you can just simply shoot it down to low health. From there, okay, you're gonna wanna shoot your RPG at the build and take out a harpoon gun. Okay, so wait until your RPG is just about to hit the wall and time your harpoon shot so your rocket goes through their wall. Your timing is gonna have to be really good for this technique, as your opponent will probably be turbo building. But if you can master the timing, you're pretty much gonna get a free 100 plus damage at the start of your fight, which is, you know, really nice considering how simple the technique is. So the next technique is another really easy one that's gonna help you out a ton. To do this one, simply pickaxe a wall just like you're replacing it. But when the wall breaks, place a ramp instead of the wall. Then immediately switch to your wall in as a short a time as possible so you can replace both. This is gonna be so amazing, guys, because, you know, not only do you have a pretty solid chance of getting both the wall and the ramp and being able to just simply mongrel classic or just go for a peek, but even the worst case scenario, man, you're gonna have a ramp in your opponent's box and you're gonna be able to continue pressuring them. When you actually think about this, there really aren't any downsides to this technique, so it's definitely worth using in fights. You know, another thing you should consider doing is carrying grenades into mid and end game. This is basically a free elimination point, guys. Start looking around and just place a marker on the top part of each base you see. If you see one that's around 65 meters away, you're in the perfect position to get an easy kill. Okay, so simply set up 65 meters away on the same height level that they're at. Look about 80% of the way up your marker and just start spamming all your grenades. This will basically guarantee, if you do this correctly, that your grenades will explode just when they hit the top of your opponent's box. And if you do this successfully and they aren't expecting to be naded, you're basically guaranteed to get a kill. This is just like pretty much as close as it's gonna get to a free kill, guys, apart from just hitting a headshot snipe or having your opponent's game crash. All right, guys, so this is gonna be it for today's video. So let's do a quick recap on everything we talked about. First off, always be consistent with your drop spot apart from, you know, straight up just W key games. It's 10 times better to know one spot perfectly than to know every spot decently. So practice getting a perfect drop and having the best loot route so you can dominate in early game fights. It's just super important, man, to know when you should and shouldn't take fights, period. So you gotta be sure to analyze each fight before you hop in. This is gonna help you guys ensure you're not putting yourself into a bad situation. Okay, so if you're playing in Cash Cups, it's crucial to have good mechanics. Once you're confident and creative, okay, you gotta start playing Arena, Pubs, or just Customs to practice W King and getting kills. This is gonna help you guys get into more realistic situations and bring you ahead of the curve in terms of fighting. Carrying an RPG or a sniper, or even both. It's just a simple and low skill way to get easy kills, all right? Definitely carry these whenever you can to increase your chances of getting free elimination points and better loot. Okay, so if you RPG a wall and time a harpoon shot when it goes through, you're gonna get a pretty easy high damage hit, potentially over 100 damage depending on your RPG rarity and damage value. If you use the wall replace trick we showed, you're going to be able to catch opponents off guard and get easy piece control, and potentially, you know, get a free angle or an opportunity to do the Mongrel Classic. Finally, if you set up your opponent's level 65 meters away and look 80% of the way up your marker, you're going to be able to get a free kill almost every single time, assuming you do it correctly. So this has been an absolutely fun video, but unfortunately, guys, you know, we're gonna have to end it right here. I hope you all enjoyed this video, enjoyed using these tips and tricks to perform better in your next cups, and even have a chance of grabbing some of that cash while doing so. If you enjoyed this video, we'd appreciate it a ton if you could drop a like, consider subscribing, and also share the video with a few friends if you think that'll help them, you know. Finally, head on over to ProGuys.com if you want to improve and get one step closer to making money in these tournaments. All right, guys, once again, we'll see you next time.